Though humanity came into the world as one species, united with one origin story, division too has always been deeply rooted in our nature. From the very beginning, life consumed life in a competition of all against all to live and pass along one's genes to a future generation. And it remains true today that in order for animal life to survive, it must consume other life. Large-scale cooperation between individuals in a species is a rare trait. Ants evolved it, forming colonies where different ants do different jobs to work together to support the colony as a whole, as have some species of bees and wasps. In mammals, this trait is even rarer. It exists among mole rats who communally raise their young. Through the use of language, humans have developed the ability to take social cooperation to another level. As some individuals learned the awesome potential power of cooperation, perhaps the most meaningful and beautiful event occurred in the history of the universe. Human beings began caring for each other. To keep their groups unified, humans learned to distinguish right from wrong. How should we share the spoils of the hunt? How should we divide labor? How should we keep from fighting each other when we get irritated? Humans learned of character strengths such as responsibility, respect, loyalty, fairness, and love. Together through complex cooperation, humans have achieved food abundance, built cities, saved each other's lives with medical technology, and even moved beyond our planet. All of human achievement can be seen as the result of humans working together in a larger society. Civilization would have been impossible for any single human to create on their own. But society was a later development. Tribal hostility, on the other hand, likely began far before humans did. Our closest animal cousins, chimpanzees, violently attack other groups of chimpanzees at rates far higher than humans attack other groups of humans, even having wars that can last years, demonstrating tribal conflict likely dates back to at least our common ancestor. From as far back as the Upper Paleolithic era, 40,000 to 12,000 years ago, humans made weapons and engaged in clan against clan conflict. Cave paintings from this era show people attacked by spears. The first documented human war between divided tribes, an us and a them, took place in Mesopotamia around 2700 BCE between the Sumerians and the Elamites. Such wars continue to this day. Why did we evolve with a predisposition to fight with each other? Some hypothesize that the fight for scarce resources has always necessitated competition for ownership of those resources. It was a matter of survival. But it's also true that through human cooperation we developed out of hunting and gathering limited food supplies, we invented agriculture, expanding our food supplies and the total human population along with it. There is strength in numbers. In our fight for survival, 2 is better than 1. 100 is better than 2. 1,000 is better than 100, and so on. Enlightened self-interest gave rise to society. Each individual is made more powerful and more likely to survive and pass on their genes when they become a member of a larger team. And when this happens, new possibilities for human thriving open. Individuals see that their own good is connected to the good of their neighbor, and that their own happiness can be amplified through empathy and compassion. While humanity has not and can never fully overcome the problem of scarcity, human cooperation has drastically diminished it. The development of the world's economy, with humans all over the world collaborating to fulfill the needs and desires of others all over the world, has provided an ever-growing abundance of resources never before seen in history. The development and growth of free markets has lifted billions of people out of poverty around the globe. Life no longer needs to be a zero-sum competition for limited resources. Instead, we can work together to create more. When we have enough food, shelter, and other necessary resources to sustain ourselves, we can approach our days with the belief that our best energies can be devoted to enjoying creative work with our peers beyond competing for our basic survival needs. Synergy is when we work together to give rise to a whole that is greater than the sum of its parts. Despite cooperation proving its value to human survival, still, the evolved human brain divides people into groups. Psychologists have shown that when people are categorized into groups, even when those groups are invented arbitrarily, people look positively on those within their group and negatively of those outside it. Group members judge their opponents to be less likable, less fair, less trustworthy, and less competent. Fortunately, human culture has developed to help us mitigate our divisive instincts. Our competitive nature has been channeled from the brutality of war into the pleasure of sports. And we've created ever-growing groups for people to coexist within. Families begat tribes. Tribes begat cities. Cities begat nations. Individuals formed into religious groups, uniting people across continents. Nations and religions often remain in violent conflict, but the groups have gotten larger and more inclusive, moving us closer to the one largest group that unites all of us, the human race. At the same time, however, people have attempted to move us backwards, categorizing us into even smaller groups, locked in conflict. Economic class, gender identity, race, and ethnicity have developed as tools to divide us. Leaders have often discovered that categorizing others as separate from their own people could mobilize the masses to the leader's end, using division as a tool to achieve even greater power. When a group is not seen first and foremost as fellow humans, but instead as part of a competing tribe, brutality against them can occur. Race was used to justify the conquest of fellow humans seen as lesser in Africa and America. Based on theories of competing economic classes, the Soviets killed millions of people. Based on theories of competing races, the Nazis killed millions too. Denying the common origin of all men has been the tool used throughout history to justify the domination of others. But today, the Soviets and Nazis are gone. Their divided way of viewing the world not only destroyed other civilizations, but their own as well. When we look at the places in the world today where people suffer the most, Myanmar, Sudan, Xinjiang, we find people wielding racial and ethnic division to be at the core of the problem. On the contrary, in every case where significant progress has been made in alleviating such injustices, it has come by insisting that people be treated not as categories, but as the full human beings that they are, not by vilifying some other them as the problem. Instead, recognizing the united and cooperative nature of humanity builds successful civilizations and successful individuals within them. Psychological studies have found kindness, love, humility, teamwork, and forgiveness to be amongst the character strengths that have been valued ubiquitously by successful cultures over history. The story of humanity is one unified story that we all share, but it is also in part the story of our false belief that we are essentially separate, of our development towards a more unified society, and our regressions into division, hate, and conflict. A continuing push and pull rooted in our nature as both social and tribal creatures. Today, new theories of race and identity seek still to regress us into smaller groups, pulling us further away from the one human race. These theories view racial and ethnic identities as fundamentally distinct and definitive categories that separate us. Such a practice is an attack on the very idea of humanity, when we are no longer human, but essentially black and white, Jews and Aryans. Every person on the planet today has a part to play in the human story. Continued advancement out of our tribal origins is not guaranteed. Our advancement towards a more unified, respectful, and peaceful society will only come if we act in accordance with our shared humanity. Learn more about the stories that define and unite us at FAIRstory.org.